Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nita Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandana Bande Radhika Charanodayam Gopiyano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manoharam Vancha Kalpataru Vasaki Pasindu Bevacha Patitanang Pavune Bhavaisabe Bhyo Namo Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalang Pangung Lang Haitagirim Yatki Patamahang Vande Paramananda Madhavam Vrindavai Tulsidev Vai Piyavai Kesava Sacha Snavakti Padidevi Sattvatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naruncaiva Narottam Deving Swaraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudir Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Padanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramadaksha Jagod Varanya Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishchaduham Tithas Padam Siva Virenchenutam Saranyam Vitatiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanar Vingam Yat Pada Pallavanaka Chandamani Chataya Bispurji Dakamakikapavadu Swadarsi Purna Nuragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhika Mahi Kadam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Ajanu Lambita Bhujau Kanuka Vadatu Sankirtanai Kapitaru Kamala Yatacho Visham Baru Dijavaru Jugadhar Mopalo Bande Jagat Priyakaru Karuna Bhataru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavan rupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Vagi Sajusho Badane Lakshmi Yasacha Bakshasi Yasasti Hide Sambi Vam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare, Hare. Kriya Saktan Dhig Dhig Vikata Tapaso Dhig Chajamin Dhigastu brahma aham badana parifullana jaro matina kimitana sachama visera samatyana narupasuna na kesanchit lesopi ahoha milito gauramadhuna kriya saktana dhig dhig vikata tapaso dhig chajamin dhigastu brahma aham badana parifullana jaro matina Kim etano sachamo visero samatyana naropasuno na kesanchit lesopi ahoho milito gauramadhuna. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that Sachidananda Bhakti Thakur identified himself as a sweeper of Namhatta. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told that Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as a sweeper of Namhatta. You can remember I was discussing all along about these topics on behalf of Vishva Vaishnava Raja Sabha, and I wanted to discuss about the unique acharyaship of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Actually, I already told that Namhatta is the main wing of Vishva Vaishnava Raja Sabha. At the same time, Namhatta is the main wing of Vishva Vaishnava Raja Sabha. And today, something new I like to discuss, that Gundicha Manjan is also, says this Gundicha Manjan, this procedure is also, cleaning of Namhatta, almost same. Actually, from Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhai writing, we can find so many excellent things. Siddhanta. Achaitanya midam visvam yadi chaitanya misvaram na viduhu sarva sastangyo opihi brahmanti te yana. The whole world is devoid of any consciousness. Consciousness doesn't mean, as per biological term, you have your life, that's why you are conscious. I am not going to speak such a cheap thing. Consciousness means, I am speaking about that according to the degree of your consciousness, you can identify yourself as human being. But according to the degree of consciousness, you can get value, honor. But foolish, this material world, they don't understand this point. They don't understand about this point. So, according to the degree of consciousness, we can get honor in the spiritual world. If consciousness is not there or not expressed in dormant states, like, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur discussing in Jaiva Dharma, that Supta Chetan, Vikachita Chetan, Purna Vikachita Chetan, sometime not expressed fully, or Purna Vikachita fully expressed. So, according to the degree of consciousness, we can give value, because they can get honor in this, in this spiritual world, actually. There is no consciousness, and that's why Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhai wanted to speak that Achaitanya Midam Visvam Yadi Chaitanya Misvaram Na Viduhu, because the whole source of the original source of whole Chaitanya, infinity Chetan, Chetanmay Dham, Chetanmay Vastu, anything, all the main source is actually Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's why Prabhupada Saraswati Bhagavad wanted to speak that way. Ya achaitanya vidam viswam yadi chaitanya na viduhu. If they are less interested to get in connection with Purna Chetan Vastu, then there is big problem. Then they are going to act like a man who is already overpowered by a ghost, you know. A normal man when doing normal activity, but when ghost, you know, try to get control over him, Bahar, then dangerous. Then he is doing some abnormal things. That's why Krishna Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually wanted to show Arthasira I can come. But first of all I have to say our Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami very easily wanted to represent this point, dangerous situation. He is speaking, Pisachi Paile Jatha Matichchanna Hoy, Mayabaddha Jiver Hoy, Sei Bhava Udaye. Pisachi Paile, as if when one ghost going to overpower you, in that case, how a ghost can overpower you? The first of all, that ghost watching, how much consciousness is there inside your heart at present. If that ghost can calculate, oh, there's consciousness, not so much, I can cover it up. In that case, that ghost can get entry inside your body. Be careful. This way, ghost can get control over you. If ghost can find that there is a minimum consciousness, it's almost no, then I can cover it up. But you can never get information that a big sadhu is overpowered by a ghost. It's not possible. Because full consciousness there. Those who are doing Harinam, Kirtan, taking bath in Harikatha all the time. How ghost can come and even Tantra Mantra, those who are dirty idiot, those people always try to play this kind of game. Very dirty, black magic, this, that. They like to disturb, even to Bhaktivinoda Thakur they wanted to, you know, Biskisan. This way try to disturb, but not, they cannot do it. So they failure, they get failure. So this way actually, consciousness if covered up by Maya, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is going to compare this Maya with Pisachi. Pisachi which? Pisachi paile jatha matichchanna hoy, Mayabaddha jiver hoy seibhab udoy. A bonded soul going to show that kind of, you know. That's why a sadhu actually, Rupa Goswami, but that's why writing, Prabhu, don't allow me to get the association of, you know, so those dirty, you know, material person. I don't like to be. Actually, those who are having business mentality, I am not going to speak that in the whole world all business should be stopped. I am not speaking that way. Try to follow my point. One who is not doing business, is doing with his motive to maintain family, to do seva, not dirty way. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur very in the beginning told that Shukla Virthi, he should not have black money. Follow. So I am not speaking the issue I am going to hate all businessmen. Not that. Business mentality means each and every step. Maybe you are sannyasi, you are acharya. But each and every step, you are sitting with balance sheet and profit and loss account. You are so cheap-minded. In that case, this mentality, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, na sa sevako sa boi baniko. Hey Prabhu, Nishungadev in front of, he is actually business mentality. He can never get Krishna. Those who are having business mentality, they can never get Krishna. Never, never. It's not possible. Actually, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami wanted to explain that those bonded souls, those who are overpowered by Maya, consciousness, you know, gone down due to Maya, due to the influence of Maya. In that case, he can do any activities. And what to speak about devotion? Devotional activity is only you can start if you are going out of Maya. Within Maya, with anartha, everything, Hari Bhajan possible is a new Siddhanta. We never hear this. But we can try. We can try. Not that I am anartho, I can leave Hari Bhajan. Not that. We should not stop bhajan. We can keep hope. With full enthusiastic attitude, we can start doing bhajan with a strong hope that today or tomorrow, by the mercy of your Guru Vaishnava, surely I am going to cut maya. Not that I cannot come, cut maya, how I can do it. This way, if you try to show your weakness, in infinity period, you cannot do Hari Bhajan. That's why Prabhupada told, if our whole life we are fighting with maya to cut maya, if we are not successful, then when we can start Hari Bhajan? When we can start, if our whole life is gone with fighting with maya, which is very easy task. It's very easy task. Many times I told that if we can serve pure Guru Vaishnava, then maya automatically from heart. And one point, there should not be any duplicity. Maybe I have thousands of weakness. That's not a big problem. I can speak in front of Guru Maharaj. I have this kind of weakness, Maharaj. But okay, no problem. You go on doing seva. I can look over this matter. That's not a big deal. Many such things happen. In front of Guru Padma, my Shuddha Guru, one disciple, is sannyas, actually is brahmachari, red cloth, is approaching Gurudev very, lonely, personally approaching Gurudev and speaking, Guru Maharaj, I am having some problem. What problem, my son? Actually, I am developing some attraction for that lady. What to do, Maharaj? Very, very big attraction. Okay, you go. Do your bhajan. Then after that, Gurudev going to take responsibility and praying unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan is very easy. So by your personal effort, you cannot cut your maya. If you can pray to Krishna, you cannot get in touch with Krishna. This bonded soul cannot get in touch with Krishna. Their request and everything cannot reach up to that far. So Vaishnavero Avedane Krishna Dayamay Ehano Pramar Pati Hoiven Shodai. That is the Siddhanta. We can pray unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. I have this kind of weakness, what to do, Maharaj? Then he can pray unto the lotus feet of Prabhu and automatically you can, but only thing you will have to do, there should not be any duplicity inside your heart. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Pisachi paile yatha mati channa hai, mayabaddha jiver hai, seva udhai. So long as maya going to overpower you cannot understand anything. So, first of all, association, pure association, I can discuss all in details, because today is a special day of Gundija Manjan Tithi. And what do you mean by Gundija Manjan Tithi? You only think we can take some boom, we can take some water pot and some boom and go to, we can shout, Jai Ho, Jai Ho. We can go inside that Gundicha and try to, with boon we can start our action. This much we know. But actually Gundicha Manjan has a very deep philosophy, you see. Gundicha Manjan actually, it has so many significance, First point is that according to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I can discuss, that cheto darpanam arjunam bhava mahadavagni nirvapanam seyokoiru vachandika vidharanam vidyabhudu jivanam anandanmati vardhanam patipadam purnamitva swadhanam sarvatma snapanam param vijayata sri krishna sankirtanam. Param vijayata sri krishna sankirtanam. We are not speaking that param vijayata narayana sankirtanam. No. Only param vijayata sri krishna sankirtanam, this word we can. We have a slogan. We Saraswat Gauriya devotee, we have only one slogan. What is that? Param Vijayata Sri Krishna Sankirtan. Why? Because if we do Krishna Bhajan, because with only with Krishna it is possible to exchange all different kind of rasa. It is only possible to exchange all different kind of rasa with Krishna, not with Narayan, not with Ram. So, any kind of problem there in our life, somehow by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if we can get in touch with Krishna, directly or indirectly, then all problems solve. Infinity period we are suffering also. So, okay, I can come to this discussion, but first of all, I like to speak about how to avoid asasanga. I told 1 or 2 days before, it is next to impossible to avoid asasanga. We bonded soul cannot avoid asasanga knowingly, unknowingly, very secretly. Your mind cannot understand this asasanga can come in our life, surely. But according to our attachment at the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you can get power. If you have less attachment at the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, then you cannot get that kind of chitbal. That's why it is written, Kipa karo prabhu diya chitbal. You should remember all the kirtan, this word. You know, Kipa karo prabhu diya chitbal. Chitbal means power. So Prabhu, Guru Vaishnava can give us chitbal, then we can go up. Without chitbal, that Upanishad one word, many times before I discuss, maybe you forget, that Nayam Atma Balahine Nalabhya. Nayam Atma Balahine Nalabhya. Those who are Balahin, those who are weak, for them, it is impossible to reach the lotus feet of Krishna. Nayam na ayam atma balahine nalabhya. Balahin mane, those who are weak, they cannot reach the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Not possible. Those dirty people, material people in this world, X mission, Y mission, they are going to misinterpret this Upanishad word. They are going to take undue advantage of this Upanishad. They are speaking just opposite way. They are speaking, here it is written, Nayam atma balahine nalabhya. That's mean you will have to take meat and fish, egg, everything, you know, blood and flesh, so you can get power like Asur. Without that you are weak, but they are idiot number one. They are going to misinterpret, they are going to misguide. This is their system. They don't know that the elephant is the most powerful creature in this nature. He is always taking banana tree, grass, this, that. How is possible? They don't know. They like to explain this way. Those are very wicked personalities. Maybe they are running some, you know, karmi organization, yogi organization. That's all idiot, foolish. Those Buddhists, they are not going to kill somebody, kill any animal. But anyway, it is already killed. Then he can get, they can, Buddhist can take. That's mean, if it is already killed, then you can take. That means you are going to take dead body for your approval. Somebody going to kill. That you are also responsible. This is all contaminated. That's why Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told that do you think there is any other way? Do you think there is any other way other than Gauriya Math? That's why. That is why Prabhupada told. Why Prabhupada told? Everybody can start agitation. Why Prabhupada told this way? Are why Prabhupada told you will have to reach up to that point that you can realize. Do you think there is any alternative way other than Gauriya Math that you can reach up to the lotus feet of Supreme Lord? All contaminated, all, everything. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur was told, you believe or don't believe, that's up to you, but someday you will have to believe. Someday. If luckily this kind of situation develops inside your heart, then you are 100% you are bound to believe it. It matters little that you believe or not believe. That's up to you. According to your belief, you can get result. So, Nayam Atma Pravachanayana, Nayam Atma Balahinena Labhyo, this means without Chitbal, we cannot get. Without Chitbal, we cannot go. So Chitbal, we can get from Guru Vaishnava, that is right. But The condition I told you that there should be tremendous affinity unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. That is the only medicine. Any kind of disease coming in your life, all can be solved. Guru Vaishnava Seva, Prabhupada told this thing. Now point is that, actually, we bonded soul don't understand so deep philosophy, so accurate philosophy, so accurate, so scientific, that common people even in dream cannot understand. Even in dream they cannot. Impossible. The Siddhanta Gauriya, Saraswat Gauriya society is so fine actually. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, actually, what do you mean by Sangha? Because if we try to do Gundicha Manjan externally, but we are not going to avoid Asasangha, never we can come out successful. If you at the same time doing Gundicha Manjan, at the same time you are doing Asasangha, that means you are cleaning and bringing all garbage again. Again cleaning, you are bringing all garbage again inside you. This is a system you are following. That's why you cannot clean your heart properly. This is the only reason. There should not be any demand, there should not be any desire, there should not be any contamination, anything. That's why actually, many times from Bhagavad-gita Mahapurana, you see, I told, akama sarva kama va moksha kama udaradi tivrena bhakti yogena jajeta purusham param jajeta purusham param. Anyway, if you have slight annavilas, this, that, okay. But not that with duplicity you are going to hide your weakness, annavilas, and you try to, you know, show that you are a great devotee. That is not allowed. Annavilas can be there. And all Siddha Mahatma can come to me. How I can expect? How I can expect that all Siddha Mahatma can come to me? And a bonded soul can come. So it is our duty to clean their heart. It is our duty, we can do our duty. If no duplicity is there on their behalf, they can approach the goal. That is the system. So, akam sarva kama ba moksha kama udarudhi. Akam, there is no kamana. Sarva kam, different kind of kamana vasana is there. And moksha kam. Okay, any kind of contamination there, but you cannot approach any demigod, you cannot approach. If you are udarudhi, your heart is very clean. How clean means? Your heart is very, you know, fair. When there is no duplicity in that case, jajeto purushamparam. Purushamparam means purushottama. Purushottama means Krishna. Purushottama means Krishna. Jajeto, jajeto. You must, you know, worship, you must do bhajan of jajeto purusham param, param purush. He cast, do, you know, puja of that archam, jajeto. Jajan mane or seva you can do. You can start bhajan of that. Though gradually, your heart, gradually you can clean your heart. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with discussion with Rai Ramananda, gradually going up and up, gradually from the exam lower level, Mahaprabhu in Rai Ramananda Sangbad, gradually going to ask this point, that point. So Rai Ramananda going to start from karma param, this, that, after that gyan, after that, you know, when gyan in full fledged form. What happens, how to start bhakti, what kind of bhakti is, of Prahlad Maharaj, what kind of bhakti shown by Prahlad, this says you have to go up and up, ultimately going to Brajadham, entering into Brajadham. After that, inside Brajadham, all Brajavasis there. Ultimately, after that, finally, going to show Radha Prem is the final. This way, gradually, Rai Ramananda Sangha is going, translation going on. If you can know, you can, very, very nice book, you know, all with full discussion, you know, element, in an analytical discussion, you can understand, you can enjoy. So this way actually, point is that Gundicha Manjan, first of all, we are going to Gundicha Manjan do, but we are not careful about Asasanga. If we cannot avoid Asasanga, then our Gundicha Manjan is a one kind of, useless energy. We are going to give useless energy. So Gundicha Manjan means actually, first of all, cleaning your own heart. It means acha cleaning of the heart of other Gundicha Manjan. Actually, it different kind of meaning come in from different angle. For cleaning Gundicha Manjan means cleaning your heart. Okay. And when pure Guru Vaishnava, those who are going for preaching, if they are going to clean your heart, it is also one kind of Gundicha Manjan, where they can invite Krishna to sit inside your heart. This is also. And to clean the whole Vaishnava society all over the world, which is the main activity of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava. It is also Gundicha Manjan. So, all the way you will have to think very analytically, that Gundicha Manjan doesn't mean you can take some boom in your hand and take a water pot and start washing and this. Whereas your heart, my heart is not clean as yet. So, we have seen all our Guru Varga, Srila Bhakti, Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti, Kumu Santo Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Puma Puri Goswami Maharaj, they are all going in Gundicha Manjan. What is Gundicha Manjan? They used to explain in front of devotees, before and after. Before starting and after, Kirtan and Kirtan, non-stop Kirtan going on. This way, they always wanted to clarify this point, because without this, if this Gundicha Manjan procedure is not clear to you, never you can start actual Hari Bhajan. This is the main problem. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to explain us very analytically that for bonded soul, it is not possible to avoid asasanga. Anyhow, knowingly or unknowingly, we are going to do some asasanga. We cannot get out of asasanga. Then you can pass remark, Maharaj, okay, if Asasanga is the great power, I can go to some solitary place and start bhajan. No Asasanga can be there. No man. Actually, if you go to some solitary place, you are going to carry your bonded soul with you. So, bonded mind with you. And you are bonded soul, so bonded mind is there. So, when you are going to a solitary place with your bonded mind, then your bonded mind going to get asasanga mentally, because your mind is not under your control. Anywhere you stay, may externally it is solitary place, but internally there's so many countless asasanga you can get. We can find in Gaudiya Bhajan that by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because according to their seva, some of them doing solitary bhajan, like about Srila Madhavendra Puripad Ji Maharaj, we can find Param Birakta Mauni Sarvatu Udasin. He is never going to speak anything without bhakti, not going to speak. Param Birakta, absolutely detachment, totally, and Mauna. He is not going to speak anything with anybody. Sarvatra, anything you see, anything in this world, he is totally out of any attraction. What to speak is always, indifferent attitude, udasin. And suppose if anybody going to meet him, that he can speak some material talk. That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita that Param Birakta Mauni Sarvatra Udasin. Param Birakta Mauni Sarvatra Udasin Gramma Varta Bhaye Ditiya Sangahin. It is written. Suppose if somebody is going to meet him, maybe he can speak some material word, like in front of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, some material people coming. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj always try to fly from them, even like to enter into a latrine so that they cannot disturb. When they suppose by chance some material man coming with material intention, then Babaji Maharaj also going to cheat them. What is the price of rice at present in your in your place? Rice, eh? And what is the price of land? Kata, how much? This way, Babaji Maharaj always wanted to cheat them because they are cheater. They coming with cheating, you know, propensity. The self-cheating propensity is most dangerous thing. Self-cheating propensity is so dangerous. I was on those previous days I was discussing about how nirvisheshvad, impersonalism or mayavad can come in all different forms. It is also one kind of mayavad. It is also self-cheating propensity. It can come. It cannot allow you to understand that you are following duplicity. Even you yourself cannot understand that this is duplicity what you are doing. You cannot understand. You can think, I am okay, I am very nice, I am not doing this. But very, very secretly, you are going to give indulgence to your duplicity. You cannot understand. You cannot detect. Because you are not a doctor. How you can detect? So this way, self-cheating propensity is very dangerous. Self-cheating propensity is the most dangerous thing. Even it cannot allow you to. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koityab. Try to understand this point. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koityab. Dharma artho kam moksha adi eishab. Tar modhe moksha vancha koityab pradhan. Jahan hoite Krishna bhakti hoy antar dhyan. Follow, you see. Why I speak that you have to learn Bengali to get all accurate, you know, feeling. All the time I have to explain, it will take double time. So you see. So, agyan tamer naam kohiye koityab. Agyan tamo mani? Consciousness gone down to almost zero level. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koityab tamo. Your consciousness gone down. You are already in tamagun. Tamagun means darkness of your heart. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koityab. Koityab means it is one kind of cheating. You never wanted to do Krishna bhajan. You never wanted to clean your heart by Guru Vishnu. You never wanted to get your heart cleaned by Guru Vishnu because you want to play your trick to make fool of Guru Vishnu. You never wanted to clean your heart through Harinam Sankirtan, Harikatha, by pure Guru. Never. That's why you are playing some sort of game. We are playing and life is going and we are playing. So you see, Agyan Tamer Naam Kohiye Koityab. How you can go for Gundicha Manjini if you don't understand all those basic points? Agyan Tamer Naam Kohiye Koityab. So your mind is now in ignorance, you know, Tama. Then in Tamagun you cannot even decide it is good. Even in this material world, if there's a morality factor, what is good and what is bad, that even you cannot understand. So Agyan Tamer Naam Kohiye Koityab. And this Koityab, this, you know, Koityab money, this duplicity can cover your heart with four different kind of thing, having each of them having countless branches. Categorically we can find four different kind: dharma, artho, kam, mukha, adi. Because infinity world not going out of these four factors. And Shuddha Bhakti is totally out of this area. This area is contaminated. But you don't understand. You think you are doing Hari Bhajan. Totally contaminated area. Restricted area. We should not get entry. And Shuddha Bhakti is beyond any of our material limit. is so aprakita, we cannot understand. So, Agyan Tamer Nam Kohiya Koitab, and this Koitab duplicity, having four different main branches, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Mokha, but each one of them having countless branches, but we cannot detect. So fine, you know, contamination. Contamination come in coarse form, sometimes in fine form, we cannot detect. So Dharma, Dharma means general Dharma, follow, not Bhagavad Dharma. So Dharma, Artha, Kama, you are going to get, do some Dharma karma, because after leaving your body, you can go to heaven, enjoy more and more enjoyment. This is your duplicity. You are not going to, try so that you can make your Atma free from any bondage. It is your own management. It is your own arrangement. Why you are going to blame Guru Vaishnava? You are, yourself, you are, you know, making your problem in your life. So Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. Dharma, Artha, Artha mean, you know, what we are up, when we are going to put energy in lieu, in return, what we are going to get, so that we can, you know, lead our life very prosperous way. So Dharma, Artha, and Kama mean, by Artha, by, you know, money and everything, we want to secure our life, enjoyment. We like to maintain our enjoyment, our daily life, physically, mentally, anyhow, enjoyment can even come in fine form. You cannot understand. Ah, Maharaj, I am not doing any. You are doing enjoyment, but you cannot understand in fine form. So, Dharma, Artha, Kama, and Moksha. And Kama, one point I like to speak very clearly, that all along in the history of human, you know, civilization, this has been the target all along. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. But in Satyayug, even in Satyayug, even those demons and rakshas, they wanted to allow some etiquette. Try to follow what I mean to say. I am not going to praise the demonic character, not that. But it is really a fact that those demons, they also used to follow some perfect procedure through which they can enjoy. But at present, we are lower than animal. Our enjoyment, the procedure of our enjoyment can come down to such and such dirty level that we can find that this, in the forest, those the animals, they are not following this procedure. So you understand this is the condition of the civilization. How we can expect? How you can expect to do Hari Bhajan? If you cannot rectify yourself, if you cannot understand all those secret points, so those demons and rakshas, they used to follow some procedure of enjoyment. But our mood of enjoyment, our procedure has come down to such a dirty level such that we are going to cross the limit of animal. Even those animals cannot come up to that low level. So fearful situation all over the world. Only and only one, we want enjoyment. I don't want to hear anything except my personal enjoyment facility. You are going to, so what it concerned to me? What it concerned to me? I am going to secure my own facility, this, that. So, Dharma, Artha, Kama, they want to enjoy the money they are earning, somehow they are getting, they like to secure their enjoyment of life. This is not actually human life. Human life money is not. That's why Vasishtha Muni was bound to confess that Gyane no hina pasubhi shamana. Gyane no hina pasubhi, there is no consciousness, then what is the difference between human being and animals? What is the difference? If there is, you know, same thing they are following. Same thing, those animal following and human being following. The ganena hina pasubhi shamana. So without proper consciousness, proper degree of consciousness, human being is not human being, is animal. But more than animal, I would say that more than animal. Ahar nidda bhaye maithunancha, ahar nidda bhaye maithunancha samanna metat pasubhi nama naranam. Gyano visheso adhiko naranam, gyano visheso adhiko naranam, gyane nahina pasubhi samana. So what is it? Ahar, nidra, we are all busy with this ahar, we are taking food, nidra, sleeping, bhai, we are also fearing if the money gone from, if the share market money gone down, what I can do, how I can manage. This way, different kind of fears from different angle coming in your life to put you in trouble. Always your intention, always. Tension-free life is the basic thing of bhajan. That's why Mahaprabhu told to Sanatan, because one devotee going to Vrindavan, Jagadanandamudi, Mahaprabhu speaking, you can ask Sanatan to arrange one very nice place so that I can go and start, smaran. Follow, very nicely, without any tension. Bhagavan is not intention, but nischindu hoya. It is written in Bengali, nischindu hoya, mana, without any tension. There should not be any, So this way actually, when Mahaprabhu speaking mean, it is a standard. If we are doing bhajan, because in Gita also it is written, you cannot give tension to somebody, you cannot give tension to anybody. At the same time, you should not feel tension. You should not feel tension from anybody. Because if there is annavilas, if there is dhitiya abhinivesh, then and only then the question of fear coming. Bhayam dhitiya abhinivesh sat ishat apetasya viparjaya sriti. I told you, if you at all having some tension, surely 100%, you have some tension mean, different kind of tension mean is dhitiya abhinivesh. Second, objective is there in your life. Or many objective. So boy, any kind of fear can come when you have any kind of fear can come. So in Gita it is written, you should not give tension to anybody. You should not get any tension from anybody. Because why you can get tension? If you know that everywhere you keep, if you can see your Gurudev everywhere, everywhere if you can see Guru, they are protecting you, how you can feel tension? That's why if you are feeling tension, mean you have to clean your heart. There is some duplicity still. So, bhayam dhitiyo vinivishata hasad ishadapas, this way. So, in Gita it is written, you cannot give tension to anybody, at the same time, you also cannot get any tension from anybody. Because you are doing Harivajan. Harivajan, you should think, Advaigyan Tattva is everywhere. Like Jaravaraji Maharaj, when that Vrishalpati is almost ready to cut his head in front of Bhadrakali. Almost ready. He put his head into that machine, the device, so he can cut his head. At the same time, this cutter weapon is ready. Sharp sword, ready, it is already applied, vermilion, red, and almost ready. But still then, Jarabharaji Maharaj is not going to express any tension. Hari Maharaj, what wrong I have done? What wrong I have done, you are going to cut me? It's not complaint, nothing. With full tranquility, going to stay in the same pose as was kept by that Vishalpati, but after that we find Krishna is there. So Krishna gives inspiration to Bhadrakali. You go and cut them, idiot. those who are idiot, you know, those, you know, Vrishalpati and their group, then they be coming out of his deity and started cutting. Dhruva Maharaj is tension-free, Prahlad Maharaj is tension-free, Pitama Abhishek is tension-free, even in when he is going to die, with all arrows, you know, piercing his body from different corner, but still tension-free. Follow what I say. Yudhishthira Maharaj is always tension-free. So, how many examples I can see? So, those devotees, they are always tension-free. So, now the point is that asasanga we cannot avoid somehow. So, how to avoid asasanga? Our Rupa Goswami Pad giving some advice to us. Dadati pratikinnati prichati gujjamachiti bhungyati bhujayati shaivya sarvido pritilakshanam. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving us scientific advice. He is speaking that Sangha, when you can say it is Sangha, Satsangha, Satsangha. Sangha, this word means, if there is piti, affinity, attachment. If there is no attachment, you can put Goswami Maharaj, Srila Goswami Maharaj in America or in England. No tension. No attraction there. They are out of this property of attraction and repulsion. So anyway, if there is no affinity, no attachment, then it is not actually Sangha. Suppose somebody coming in mot, your Guru Padma speaking, you can give prasadam to him, he is hungry. You are giving prasadam, but you cannot apply this formula, dadati pratikinna, because you are serving prasadam, but you have no attachment with him. Simply to do this duty you are doing. So in that case, no attachment. We are going to market here and there, to buy fruits and flour here and there, in train and bus and flights, anywhere. But always remember, if there is no attachment, no affinity, then there is no... So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, people, if they are going to solitary bhajan, they are going to put themselves in double trouble. Because they are bonded condition. Their mind is bonded condition. How they can do solitary bhajan? They cannot get control over mind. Maybe they are going externally, going away from this place and they are going from this place and going to live there in a very solitary place. But their mentally they are going to do asasanga, but always every time matters coming. Always different kind of countless matters are coming to disturb you. You can try yourself to do Hari Bhajan. You cannot do. So it is good. The advice Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving, better you can stay in front of Guru Vaishnava and go on doing Hari Bhajan like Brahmasting. Sthane sitaha sutigatam tunubang manuvir. I can stay in front of Sadhu Guru Vaishnava. I can stay in front of Sadhu Guru Vaishnava to clean my heart. There is a procedure. Not that you can take boom and water pot and go there. Ah, I have done Gundija Manjan. Same garbage is there. No, this is not possible. This procedure is that Israel we have to approach. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Sangha is a must. Bonded people can never avoid, because this society where we can go. Every time all relatives coming, even your son and daughters, they are material. You cannot throw them out. But one point you should remember, that Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj told, Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to speak, that I can stay in a very solitary place among you all. Among you all, I can stay in a very solitary place. What do you mean? It means, though you all are there around Maharaj, but Maharaj can maintain his solitary bhajan. Mean? His mind is totally resting under the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is called Nirjan Bhajan. Those are elevated devotees, while they are speaking Harikatha in front of thousands of people, all people coming to meet them, ask questions, but still, they have their capacity to maintain solitary bhajan. They are not going to get asasanga. Not possible. But those who are not established in bhajan, their mind is very weak, heart is very weak, they cannot do solitary bhajan. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is almost impossible that bonded soul cannot, because sangha is a must. Anytime we are, but we must apply this formula. There should not be attachment. If my son is too much material, I should not have an attachment with my son. If my father is too much attachment, I should not develop piti, affinity with them. So you can remember yesterday I was discussing Gauro Bimukh, Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jane Jani Paar. Maybe they are near and dear one, but you going to cut relationship. Externally you can show, like Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami going to maintain external behavior with father, mother, friends and everything, but he like to fly because his mind is totally off. His mind is, by now his mind is totally off, he like to fly. But Mahaprabhu speaking, antare nishtha karo baihe log byabohar, antare nishtha karo baihe log byabohar, achirat krishna tomai koriben uddhar. Mahaprabhu speaking to Raghunath Das Goswami, what? Mahaprabhu speaking, antare nishtha karo, inside your heart, like the example I already told 2 days ago and yesterday maybe, parabhyasananinari background vigriya karmasu tadaiva sadayati anto navasangar sayan. Like a pros lady always singing about his second, husband. He is not husband, original, hero. This kind of example given, but if you just make it opposite, I told you, this material world is a perverted reflection of the transcendental world. If you make it just opposite, if you apply for transcendental world, it becomes very, very acceptable, very nice. But when you apply in the material world, it is, derogatory. It's very, very, we should decry, we should hate. So this example Mahaprabhu giving. Even in Karunamrita, Mahaprabhu was very, very happy to see the description of, that kavi, Billamangal Thakur. I can discuss someday. So you see, always and every time we must be very careful. Here it is written that how to avoid asasanga. This is very dharma artha kamma kadiya ishab, and out of that moksha bancha. You like to get your liberation. It is the topmost of all, topmost danger. Mahaprabhu speaking, tar modde moksha bancha koitava pradhan. All duplicity that you are running from dharma, artha, because that dharma is not absolute dharma. So dharma, artha, kam, mokko, whatever you are going to do. But be careful out of that, the fourth one, the moksha vancha, kuitava pradhan, Mahaprabhu, it is topmost, dangerous. Because you cannot get bhakti anyhow. Tar modde moksha vancha koitava pradhan jaha hoite krishna bhakti hoy antodhyan. You can never get krishna bhakti because you are going to get moksha liberation, impersonal idea. You can do the submerge. In that case, it is great offense. And other sloka I told you, akama sarva sarva kama mukha kama udarati, they can get someday. Today or tomorrow, or maybe after thousands of years, next birth, next life, next birth, they can get scope by the mercy of Guru Vishnu. But this moksha vancha, those who are having, is great offense, they cannot get bhakti, very dangerous. If they can change their heart, somehow by the mercy of Guru Vishnu, somehow, quite impossible, if somehow, like that Prakasananda Saraswatipada was changed by the mercy of Mahaprabhu. It is possible. It is not possible, but still it can be possible. So you see, here actually, we actually how to avoid asasanga. This is a very secret point. Then, if you have no attachment with your father, their material actually son, then you can do normal. You know, to Raghunath Mahaprabhu speaking, externally you can maintain, maintain karsi. You can go on doing behavior, but internally you should have strong affinity unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Antara nishtha karo, baihe logbe, baihe. Externally you go on saying that you are staying like everybody, you are also leading your life this way. So this is the procedure those grihastha people can follow, no other way, because everybody cannot cut, you know, material, you know, samsara and go. This is not possible. But for those big sadhu like Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, actually, to be frank, they are all doing, externally they are doing all solitary bhajan. But their solitary bhajan mean, inside their heart, always they are getting the sangha of Vaishnava. Their solitary bhajan, you can speak, they are also doing solitary bhajan. They are not doing solitary bhajan, they are externally solitary bhajan. But inside heart, always Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan always appear inside your heart. So, it is externally you can find it is in a solitary bhajan, but still it is not solitary. Sanatana Goswami, always writing books and this, that, doing kirtan. Already you know the Sarva Goswami is talking. Eh? All the time they are doing sankirtan. All the time, writing this. They have no time actually, parikram, all the time. This way, though externally you can find they are doing solitary bhajan, but it is not at all solitary bhajan. And Madhavendu Puripad actually, for pratishtha, pratishtha is one kind of contamination. Pratishthar bhayapuri gala palaya. People in the morning time give me pratishtha, that's why. So how they are cleaning their heart? Their heart is clean. Their heart is always clean, but still we like to follow this procedure. You see, they are not going to allow any contamination to come in their heart. Because their heart is Namhatta, their heart. They are going to distribute Harinam and Katha. So if their heart, if their, you know, market is contaminated, how they can do? So even they are not going to ask anything. Ajachita Bitti Puri Virakta Udas. Ajachita Paile Khan Nahi Upobash. Without any demand, if somebody is going to give milk, then going to accept, otherwise fasting. Because always, you know, saturated. Because they are drinking the nectar of Harikatha, Harikirtan. Namanande, you know, always is satisfied with Namananda. Khudatishna, Varayana, hunger and thirsty cannot put them in trouble. So this kind of Nijan Bhajan is totally separate. If you are going to Nijan Bhajan, it's dangerous. So what you have to do? You have to stay in front of pure Guru Vaishnava. And you cannot allow asasanga in your life. This is your first step. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, actually, that when we are making one Virat, you know, Dharma Sabha, this, that, function, you know, Utsav, this, that, in that case, different kind of people can come. Dharma Sabha, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you know the meaning of Sabha? You know the meaning of Sabha. What do you mean by Sabha? Sabha means, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining, that Sabha means where Vaishnava, those pure Vaishnava can stay. Where pure Vaishnava can sit. Sabha means those who are sabha. Sabha means they are gentle, really gentle. Those Vaishnavas, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, sabha means those, you know, most gentle, you know, behavior, those Guru Vaishnava. When they are going to sit in one place, it is called sabha. And if all external people also coming, this is called mixed sabha. In mixed sabha, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining that in mixed sabha, we cannot discuss about rasa tattva. Not possible. Because it is impossible. Those who are pure devotees, we can go through Jaiva Dharma, we can find how contamination going on. I am going to detect it and I am going to project it in front of you. Why I told that if 500 years given to me and if my lifespan going to cross that limit, but still it is not possible. So much garbage already created, you know. Shuddha Bhakta, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, there's pure devotion in Sajjanta Sani, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, pure devotion is almost rare. A precious jewel, almost impossible. And how we can expect then? Because what is Ishtagoshti? How satsanga is possible? Sriman Mahaprabhu already in his, you know, Leela already shown us. But we are so blind, we cannot see. Mahaprabhu going to request Rai Ramananda Sarvadamoda to sing something. Here, Mahaprabhu hearing Harikatha and Kirtan for Rai Ramananda Sarvadamoda. Sometime Mahaprabhu going to Gadadhar Pandit and requesting you speak for Lat Charitra to me. This way all the time, after changing the heart of Sarvam Vattacharya, Mahaprabhu sometime going there. This way, Mahaprabhu already sometime in the Bhajan Kutir of Haridas Thakur. This way all the time, Mahaprabhu is showing us how to do satsanga. And when special satsanga, special ishtagasti, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, first point is that pure devotion is almost rare. Second point is there, how we can expect, how we can expect that so pure sadhu, so many pure sadhu can come in one place and discuss some rasa tattva. Whereas pure sadhu is almost rare in this world. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, first point is pure devotion is rare. How we can expect that those pure devotees can come and it is rare, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we cannot expect that kind of meeting is almost rare. Two or three or four, I don't know, is almost rare. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking from his life history, biography, from his, I can discuss someday. Today, no time actually. Ishtagoshti, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Ishtagoshti is two type of Ishtagoshti. First of all, I like to say, the Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, with common people, those who are having no idea about rasa tattva, everything, if I going to sit with them in a room and try to speak about Ujjal Nilmani, this, that, or rasa tattva, or, you know, Vidagdha Madhav, Sangeet Madhav, how it is possible? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, with common people, those who are not having any basic idea of bhajan, we cannot discuss any rasa tattva. In that case, we cannot expect any support of rasa tattva. We cannot any get enjoyment. On the contrary, we are going to commit aparadh, we are going to break our rasa. Rasa bhanga. In Bengali, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that kind of goshti is totally useless, offensive, because it's a rasa bhanga. You cannot get rasa, you cannot expect. At the end of the day, it is rasa bhanga. Cross connection of rasa, aparat unto the lotus feet of rasa. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur again, that kind of rasa tattva charcha discussion is not at all possible in open. Not at all possible in open. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I think, is Sajjanta Sani. Second point, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Ishtagoshti is actually, Ishtagoshti mean, first of all, what do you mean by Ishtagoshti? How you can clean your heart? One by one I am speaking this all scientific points through which continuously you can try to reach that point, to make your heart clean, clear. Ishtagoshti means Suppose I am going to make an ishtagoshti with you two or three. Suppose. But ishtagoshti means actually my ishtadev is Chaitanya Chandra. And if your ishtadev is Ramchandra, then Rasa Tattva, how I can discuss? If somebody like Rupa Sanatana going to request his brother Anupam, we two doing Krishna Bhajan, actually you are doing Ram Bhajan, it's okay, no problem. But still, Krishna, if you want to get the full trust, maximum trust, then you must switch over to Krishna Bhajan is good. Murari Gupta doing. So, it's one special case with Murari Gupta. I can discuss after. So, you see, this way actually, Ishtagoshti, when we are doing, then our Ishtadev, your Ishtadev, my Ishtadev, his Ishtadev must be same. And we must be of almost the same category, then Ishtagoshti. Because without that, Ishtagoshti is not possible. If there is too much difference in feeling, then Ishtagoshti cannot stand. So, Ishtagoshti means all same. Sajati rasaya snigde sadhu sango satobare. Rupa Goswami was writing, Je sadach sajati rasaya snigde sadhu sango satobare. Sajati rasaya means, if you are going to get the association of some sadhu who is in the line of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, surely, if it is not at all in the line of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, you must throw him. Maybe he is a world famous acharya. You can throw him out. Garbage. So, first point actually here. So, Rupa Goswami was speaking, Sajati rasaya snigde sadhu sango satobare. Sajati rasaya snigde. Sajati rasaya means the same ras. Maybe there is a slight difference, but almost same ras. He is from different, you know, feeling. Then Rupa Goswami was speaking, Sajati rasaya snigde. Ashaya means your expectation of bhajan, your goal is almost same. But maybe bhajan power is a little different, and realization also. Little bit there is a difference. So, this kind of ishtagoshti is possible. Sajati rasaya snigde, sadhu sanga satobare. Satobare means very, very excellent. Sajati rasaya snigde, sadhu sanga satobare means very, very excellent. This kind of sadhu sanga, if you can do, same sampradaya. Because if you are going to get sadhu sanga from different sampradaya, you cannot expect any rasapusti. You cannot expect any nourishment of rasa. Because you are in Gauri Sampradaya, you are going to mix with Ramananda Sampradaya, you cannot. But I am not speaking any Ramananda Sadhu coming, you can throw him. Not that. You can do seva, but regarding your Siddhanta Vichar, you must be very careful. So that he cannot overpower you. All the time, in the preaching field, you know, we cannot find any such devotee who is standing on neutral platform, like Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They always want to give you maximum benefit. But this is not the common sense. In general, it is not so. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking so many things, maybe next Harikatha, after tomorrow, because tomorrow is totally different kind of discussion I will have to discuss about Sarasiki Seva, how to do Seva, what is the mood of Vajagopis, all very secret things. So, Ishtagoshti, two types of Ishtagoshti. One is Achar and is Pachar, Ishtagoshti. Those who are busy with Acharan, they are Bhajan Parayan, Sadhu. They are always busy with Sankirtan, Harikatha, Harikirtan, Savanga, all the time. And some are busy, they are doing bhajan, at the same time going for preaching. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is suggesting, those who are going for preaching, they surely can get maximum kripa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his lila has shown how to do bhajan and distribute kripa. But this is not a matter of joke. If you have no kippa, no power, nothing, how you can go to make garbage in the society, in the whole world? You have nothing. You are not established in bhakti. Eh? Then why are you going for preaching to make garbage? So I can discuss so many things what Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. So at the time of preaching, those who are going for preaching on behalf of Gauriya Society, Saraswat Gauriya Society, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, at the time of preaching, Bhagavat Tattva, Jeev Tattva, Nam Mahima, time to time, according to situation and circumstances, they can discuss. Not that everywhere they can start discussing Rasa Tattva, everything. Not strictly prohibited. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if you all challenge, I can give you in quotation all in details. Sajjanta Suni, which chapter, where, don't try to put any challenge. So, at the time of preaching, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhagavat Tattva, Jeev Tattva, Nam Tattva, according to their, you know, right, adhikar, you will have to speak all about this Tattva. But Rasa Tattva, not everywhere. Rasa Tattva strictly prohibited, in openly it is not allowed. And so those pure devotees, they are staying in solitary place, you can see, but actually they are going to do bhajan, sankirtan all the time. They are feeling that Supreme Lord is Sonatan Rup all the time. Jiva Gosikan all the time, they are busy with some other. Through sastra, writing, reading, the kirtan, parikram, you know, anywhere they go, their each and every breathing is Hari Bhajan. So how we can change our, you know, mood of bhajan? Because our actually, if we like to do Hari Bhajan, I am in the procedure shown by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. I am less interested about any procedure shown by any acharya. I am less interested. I am speaking those who are going to follow, interested to follow Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, they must try to rectify themselves through this procedure of Gundicha Manjan. Through this procedure. All the time they must follow this procedure. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, First of all, this technique you should know how to avoid asasanga in your daily life. Each and every fraction of second, you must know this technology. This very fine technology, how to avoid asasanga and how to get in touch with satsanga continuously. Niravachinna satsanga, uninterrupted satsanga. Then you can come out successful, siddha. You can come out successful in your bhajan. Now, according to Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can find there is Gundicha Manjan. So, this Gundicha Manjan procedure, be careful. This procedure of Gundicha Manjan shown by Parat Parakhileshwar, Supreme Lord, I mean, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Previously, before Jagannath Dev Rath Yatra, it was not the procedure. But, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to show this procedure. What is this procedure? But actually, of course, when Jagannath coming to Gunjita Mandir, before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance, there was also one kind of cleaning, but the deep philosophy. What I mean to say, somebody can, before Jagannath coming, maybe 1,000 years before, 800 years, also there was one procedure of cleaning, but I'm not speaking about that, I'm speaking about the exact philosophy. Gundicha Mandir, with what mood, what procedure Gundicha Mandir going on. That was already started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu suddenly expressed his desire to go for Gundicha Manjan. King Pratap Rudra got information. Accordingly, he is getting ready to help Prabhu, sending his messengers, you know, servants, go there. Whatever Prabhu demand for the seva, whatever thing is, immediately arrange anything. Prabhupada speaking, Prabhu speaking, Raja giving, it is a standing order of king. So everything was arranged. All thousands of, you know, pitcher, mud pitcher, boon, everything all clear, cleaning instruments, everything. And in the morning time, very early in the morning, Prabhu started kirtan, and with all devotees, Prabhu, you know, dancing and going towards Gundicha Manjin. Actually, Prabhu used to stay in Gombira. Try to understand. And you try to calculate the distance. If I ask you, you will have to go to Gombira. Oh, Maharaj, there is no auto, no toto. How I can go? Foolish number one. How we can go in? You will have to run 40 kilometers. You forget that you are sadhu. Eh? You forget. You are sadhu. Eh? You cannot run. How you can do seva? Then Mahaprabhu going from Gundicha Mandir up to Mahaprabhu from Gambira up to Gundicha Mandir. Then with full enthusiastic attitude doing, because we are going to clean and the temple. Then all devotees singing. Also, I like to give you a reminder at the time of our Guru Varga, great Guru Varga, like our Bhakti Devita Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Srila Santo Goswami Maharaj, you know, Srila Mahadev Goswami Maharaj sometime joining, and Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, they all, oh, so, even in dream I cannot see, oh, impossible. That kind of enjoyment I like to get now. How I can get? My luck is very bad. Thy Narottama Thakur crying, Se Sangana Paiya Kande Narottama Das. Narottama Thakur crying. Because Narottama Thakur always expecting that kind of Sangha. So it's excellent. I cannot describe any amount of lecture, any amount of philosophy is philosophical, you know, description is not equal to what happened on those times. Very beautiful. They are all going there to do Sankirtan. They are doing full Sankirtan with Midanga. So many bigger. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj is also playing Midanga this all the time. After that, reach there and put all their instrument, playing instrument, and they all by the order of, you know, Mahaprabhu. They all Mahaprabhu Jabe Agga Dila. When, as and when Mahaprabhu issue the order, go and start Gandhiji. Everybody started dry cleaning. First dry cleaning was, you know, Mahaprabhu also doing with one boom. Very nice cleaning. After that, Mahaprabhu giving them, you know, inspiration. Hey, I'm going to clean and you all are cleaning. Let us see who can clean very nicely. If I see that your, you know, collection of your dirty thing, I mean dust particle and, you know, stone chips, you know, less, if I find, then I can give you punishment. What kind of punishment? You will have to bear the expenses of Mahaprasadam. This punishment. I'm going to give you punishment. What punishment, Prabhu? Actually, if you are not cleaning properly, then I can give you punishment. What punishment? You have to arrange and the prasadam for all. I mean, to bear expenses. Prabhu like to make balance. He is not able to clean properly. So why not he is going to balance with Vaishnava Kripa, give them prasadam. So Mahaprabhu going to make anyway final in a balancing. Prabhu is very clever. After that, everybody cleaning and everybody shouting Krishna Nam. Without Krishna Nam, Mahaprabhu never doing any seva. They are doing cleaning seva going on, dry cleaning and giving, always speaking Harinam, and in between, time to time, Haribol, they are shouting so loudly, like, you know, this, you know, sky going to break down. So nice. They are, you know, they are shouting, and Prabhu also giving the inspiration. No, this way you'll have to clean, huh? After that, it was found, Prabhu collecting, you know, after dry cleaning is done, all devotees, they are cleaning. If all their share, I mean, how much dust they collect, if you put in one place, all them, and Mahaprabhu alone, more than them. Because he is Supreme Lord. So his dust particles more, you know. After that, they're going to throw it outside and started now water cleaning. When Mahaprabhu giving order, all devotees running towards Narendra Sarovar. Indodumna Sarovar. Narendra Sarovar is there, where Jal Khela and, you know, Chandan Yatra going on. Indodumna Sarovar is little near. They are going to Indodumna Sarovar to collect water from that. And all the thousands of devotees are coming and giving to Prabhu. Prabhu started cleaning and, you know, so nice cleaning. Going on, this kind of cleaning seva, Prabhu going to teach us, to Jivatma, try to understand. Until and unless your heart is clean, so much clean, we cannot expect Krishna to sit inside your heart. So automatically, if you are interested to do Gunjita Manjan, if you are interested to do Krishna Bhakti, it's an automatic factor. You cannot avoid Gunjita Mandir. Anyway, you'll have to do. I am also cleaning Gunjita Mandir through Harikatha today. What to do? So, they actually, Prabhu giving them order, they are coming with water pot, all cleaning, and Sankirtan going on. In between, one Gaudiya devotee, very plain-hearted Brahman, very nice. He is coming, and suddenly he is going to put he is going to throw the water onto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Though internally Mahaprabhu is very happy, but still externally Mahaprabhu is saying very angry, "Hey, what you are doing?" As that Gaudiya is very afraid, Prabhu shouting, "Hey, what you are doing? What you are doing? In this Jagannath temple, where the cleaning going on, you foolish, you give me water on my lotus feet, where I can reach? He Ram, great aparad done by you. Hey, you call Sarup, where is Sarup Gosai?" Then Karun, "Sarup, you see, Sarup, you see the condition, you see. Very, you know, foolish, you know, your Gaudiya is doing this kind of mischievous activities. You see, putting water inside Jagannath temple. Oh my God, where I can reach, eh?" Sarup Gosai is very intelligent. Sarup Gosai understand the mood of Prabhu. Then Sarup Gosai going to catch that Gaudiya devotee with a neck and going to throw him out of Gaudiya Mandir. "Go outside. You are doing all mischievous activities." He's crying, "I cannot do anymore. Please allow me. I cannot leave." Then again he's coming and begging for. This way actually Sriman Mahaprabhu going to give instruction to all our Gaudiya that Tomar Gaudiya kare etek phoijati. Your Gaudiya going to this kind of mischievous activities. Mahaprabhu giving indication. Through this indication, also by action also all the time, also by action, not that only indication. Mahaprabhu always wanted to indicate Sarup Gosai is the top head of all Gaudiya Vaishnava society. Not only indication. Anytime Raghunath Das Gosai asking, Raghunath Das Gosai wanted to get some advice from Mahaprabhu directly. But Mahaprabhu speaking, I already indicate you that your guru is Sarup Gosai. So you should ask anything, any tattva, siddhanta, any kind of interrogation, any kind of curiosity you have. Yeah. I don't know. A vast knowledge is there with Sarup. Amiyo na jani, iho jani jato. I am also not knowing so much theory and siddhanta. He is knowing. I already indicate you that, sir, I already hand over you unto the lotus feet of Sarup Gosai. Why not you ask? At all, if you are interested about my, okay, let me speak one or two, you know. Then after that, Mahaprabhu started, I already speak. But still, if you have some interest about my advice, okay, let me speak. After that, Mahaprabhu speak. Gammo katha na koibe, gammo vata na sunibe, bhalo na khaibe, bhalo na puribe. Niskinchan hoya sada Krishnanam labe. Very secret advice. It is the top secrecy of Raganuga Bhajan. Very secrecy. Very nice. Now actually, we Gauriyas should always understand, always feel the instruction of Mahaprabhu is that Swarup Gosai is our leader, topmost authority, Swarup Gosai. Anybody going to get anything, also he is going via Swarup Gosai, not directly. So Swarup Gosai, because Vaha Sampradaya Prabhupada used to speak Swarup Rup Raghunath, Swarup Rup Raghunath, this word Prabhupada used to speak, you know. So Swarup Gosai is the total response, I mean, total, you know, authority, topmost authority. Through this Gaundicha Mandir, we can get indication that anything we are doing, anything we are doing, we can try to prove that we are doing bhakti, but it should be approved by Swarup Gosai. Because in Shastra we get that if any kind of unauthentic activities is not allowed. Shuti Siti Puranadi, Shuti Siti Puranadi, Pancharating Bidhing Mina. Vaikantika Harir Bhakti Utpatai Bhakatpati. Which is not supported by Shuti Siti Puranadi, Pancharating Bidhing Mina, which is not going to get the support of Pancharating Vidhan. And after all, I like to say, which is not going to support previous Guru Varga, which is more accurate, more scientific. Because Shastra word, what is written where, I can understand, I cannot understand. It depends how much kripa I have. So why not you go to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada? It's very easy. Very easy. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to present all Shastra Siddhanta in such a catchy way that in infinity period, we cannot expect. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to represent all Siddhanta Vichar in such a catchy way, so easy representation, so catchy way, that in infinity period we cannot expect. So nice representation, each and every time Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to protect us from danger imminent. This kind of accuracy nobody can maintain. Whole life you will have to follow Bhaktivinoda Dara. You will have to go on hearing, you can go mad. Oh, this kind of accuracy there. Even in, you know, even in coming thousands of births, we cannot even imagine. That kind of accuracy is there, spoken by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We are so bad luck, so bad luck, so foolish, so foolish, so foolish. We cannot follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada properly. We cannot follow him properly. We are very unlucky. That's why I told you, na? Someday, Prabhupada striking his own head with his hand. You know? Hand. Oh, 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 Supreme Lord, oh, Bhagavan. I wanted to give them so many secret things, but they are going, they are running just opposite way. In infinity period, we cannot pay to Prabhupada. In infinity period, we cannot pay to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Not possible. We are heartless, merciless we are. So merciless. We are going to go against Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. So heartless that in infinity periods, we cannot get bhakti. We are so heartless. So we must be careful. All the time we will have to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Even in the autobiography of Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing that I wanted to start solitary bhajan. I thought in my service period or all these that I have done, so I have done something by the mercy of Supreme Lord. Now after retirement and everything, I can finish and go to for solitary place. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I wanted to stay in Radhakund, this, that. But in the meantime, when I went to Tarakeshwar, Hooghly, for some office job. Then in the night time, Tarakeshwar Sadasiv coming in my dream and speaking, "Hey, you have taken decision to go away from here to do solitary bhajan? What? Who can do the seva of this Gaurdham? It is also Vrindavan. It is also secret Vrindavan. Eh? Who can do this seva? It is due with you." "Oh, really?" After that, in the morning time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, after completing his seva, come back and took decision not to go to Radhakund to stay. Sometimes they used to go, but not to stay there permanently. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur took responsibility because they are the eternal prasad. And by the desire of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj also took decision to come here in Gaurdham. Previously Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj was there in Nandagram, here they are doing bhajan. By the desire of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, again he is also coming here to stay here in Kulia. Eh? Padosevan Khetro, they are Kulia Deep, there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also, and Jagannath Babaji Maharaj, you also know. Why? They wanted to preach. They wanted to project the unique mercy of this Gaurdham. Why Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj came? Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj came from Surya Kundo, where I was there, near Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, same temple. I mean, almost this side and that side. So there, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, from there, suddenly by the mercy inspiration of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, coming here in Gaurdham and taking settlement in Padasaman Khetra, Kulia, they are also at the bank of Ganga, started doing bhajan. So this way you find all Mahajan, they wanted to project the excellent glory of Gaurdham, and at the same time it has some link with Gundicha Manjan. Because if you like to clean your heart, the easiest procedure is to do seva of this Gaurdham. It has some link with Gundicha Manjan. If you like to clean your Gundicha Manjan heart, it is the easiest procedure, that you can take shelter of Gaurdham. At the same time, you can serve some Gauranga devotee who is more and more merciful, more and more merciful, more compassionate, more compassionate. They can show compassion to us very easily. So even Jagai Madai should not speak that way, because I am more and more lowest creature than Jagai Madai. Yeah, 100% perfect. Because Jagai Madai, they are lucky. They could see the lotus feet of Gauranga directly. They are lucky. They got the mercy of Gauranga and Nityananda Prabhu. Eh? So they are lucky. That's why Krishnadas Kavijaya Goswami is speaking. So how much their heart is clean? The more your heart is clean, the more your heart is clean, the more you can find your heart is going to, you know, going to express humble attitude. If your heart is not cleaned, then anyhow by your personal effort, you cannot sow humble attitude. You can sow, but it is some kind of duplicity. Actual heart is cleaned, you can understand when Guru Vaishnava is really. Maybe they are speaking heavy harikatha, heavy speaking, but not then they are merciless. They are more and more and more merciless than any, you know, devotee who is going to show some normal mercy, humble attitude in front of you. Because Krimikanta wanted to kill Ramanujacharya, simply because he wanted to project the absolute truth. It's a normal history, it's usual. In the history of human civilization, if you go and check up, you can find any time, any pure devotee going to speak about all about this absolute truth, without any smell of any self-interest, always whole world going to attract him. It's a natural, quite natural. Because they are, anyway, they are not going to make any compromise with anybody. Because compromise is not allowed in pure devotion. Pure devotion, that doesn't, actually pure devotees, they can excuse you. Some mistake done, yes, that's different thing. But compromise is totally different. Compromise means you will have to come down to the low standard. living the actual Siddhanta absolute. In the way of absolute, we have no right to change our Siddhanta, change our, you know, mood, everything, nothing. We have no right to speak wrongly in a very lucid way. Eh? I can change the philosophy of Prabhupada, nobody can change. You are idiot. This we cannot do. Because I heard from Guru Bhargava, how you can change the word of Prabhupada? You yourself cannot understand. Each and every word of Prabhupada is weighted, very wet, Guru. Each and every word spoken by Prabhupada, each and every word written by Prabhupada is just very heavy weight, heavy weight. Heavyweight, it is Guru Vastu. See, if you touch and try to destroy this Guru Vastu, then you are Mayavadi. You are Mayavadi, impersonalist, like Jarasandha and Kamsa. You are not devotee. Maybe from you, any society you are from. I am not going to pass away. It is Siddhanta. You are going to change. Eh? How dare you change? You don't know Guru Tattva, nothing, no seva, nothing, only out of your money power, you like to say, I can conquer the whole Maya. Can you? Can you? Is possible? Without the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava? Eh? You want to maintain some particular. In my society, my society, foolish number one. What society? There is one society. There is one and single society in the whole world. That is Gauriya Vasa society. Saraswat Gauriya society. You have no right to form a separate society. You have no right. Already shown by Prabhupada. Separate society. Separate. All separate. Duplicity. Now, actually, we will have to understand the inner meaning of this Gundicha Manjir. This all you have to... Don't forget. Don't forget all the secrecy I speak one by one. You have to remember, digest. If you go on hearing, not going to digest, not going to remember, how are I can do? I cannot do. To save you, it is actually the exact medicine. It is the exact medicine through which you can cure your material disease. And you can start actual Krishna bhajan. Exact medicine you will have to apply in your life. Not that you can hear some philosophy, somebody going to memorize some philosophy so that he can speak to somebody. This is actually not good. First of all, you will have to digest in your life. First of all, you will have to digest all Siddhanta Vichara, you will have to digest in your life. And then you can think of, you are going to die. Who is going to save you? Eh? Who is going to save you? You are going to save others. Try to save yourself. Try to justify with yourself first. You are thinking about their material, how to save them. Are you a material? Try to save yourself first. Eh? You are going for pitching to make some garbage, more and more garbage in the society. Eh? Krishna bhakti bina nahi bhakti pavartan. Without Krishna bhakti, you have no right to go for pitching. Without Krishna bhakti, you have no right to go for pitching. If you don't have Krishna bhakti, what you can preach? Preaching means you will have to influence, change their heart. How you can change? Through Siddhanta Vichara. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, until and unless they are totally established in Siddhanta Vichara. Totally. Until and unless they are going to follow themselves, what they are going to speak. They have no right to go for preaching. Only they can make some disturbance. They can make some disciple. We call unauthentic children. And illegal children, disciple, illegal children, illegal, you know, illegal children, they can make all over the world, making some garbage, some tilak mala and fighting, oh, corruption, you know, this. So, Gundicha Mandir is these topics we should understand under the guidance of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Kesav Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami, Sridhar Goswami, we must understand. Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, otherwise all useless. Basic thing of bhajan we don't understand. If I ask one question to, what do you mean by bhajan? In one word, I like to get answer. To seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord, total satisfaction. This is called bhajan. You forget this point. You forget this point that to seek the total satisfaction. To seek the total satisfaction, to seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord is called actually to seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. To seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord is called bhajan. You forget this point. Bonded soul, each and every fraction of second, they are going to seek their own interest. Bonded soul, anyhow, they are going to seek their self-interest. So how they can start Hari Bhajan? And the sloka is started, I like to explain this, you know, little bit. This sloka is very important actually, you know. Very interesting sloka. Kriya asaktan adhik, bikata dabad adhik. This sloka is very important. And this sloka actually speaking that those who are busy with karma kanda, those who are always busy with their karma kanda, kriya saktan, they are too much attachment to material activities. We are going to express phai, chi, in Bengali we say, kriya saktan dhig bigota taposo. You are going to show that you are developing renouncement, dry vairagya. Mahaprabhu become very angry. We cannot so dry vairagya. Yukta vairagya, I always discuss, you can remember. Non-irvinno nati shakto, Prabhupada speaking, used to speak. Non-irvinno nati shakto bhakti yoga asya siddhido. Who can get success in Shuddha Bhakti? Non-irvinno. He is not totally detached, expressing hatred. Nati shakto, no too much attachment is there, nothing. But the point is that in the name of Yukta Vairagya, we are going to run into hell. Everybody, almost everybody, in the name of Yukta Vairagya, they are going to enjoy. They are going to take undue advantage. Oh, it is there, Yukta Vairagya reading. Yukta Vairagya. They understand Yukta Vairagya. In the name of Yukta Vairagya, they are going to do all nonsense. You see. So first of all, kriya saktan adhik. If you have too much attachment for material activities, you believe in material activities, we express, you know, sorry for you, dhik. And bikata tapasa, those who are going to take up too much, you know, astridian finances, for them, we also express, you know, sorry, dig phai, jamin. Digosu Brahma, who is going to express with, you know, laughing, you know, with all 32 threats. Ah, I am Brahma. I am Brahma. Okay. As going to laugh and opening the full set of threats. You know, digosu Brahma ham, badana pari fullana jado matina. He is a material. He is material. You know. How much we can express, you know, our sorry for them. Kim etano sochamo vishayaro samattano naroposuno. They are naroposu. They have two legs. But they are animal with two legs. Vishayaro samattano naroposuno. They are beast. So, because they, up to now, I think, never they meet with the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. na kesanchit leshopi ahaha milit gauram madhuna. Glories, what I say, maybe now they have, that through the Harikatha of Guru Vaishnava, you can have the chance to see the lotus feet of Gaur mean, not that directly Gaur coming in and see. You should understand. So through Harikatha, Harikitan, if you can see inside your mind, heart, the lotus feet of Nityananda Gaur, so Kriya Asaktyan Adhik, Bikatatapasya Adhik Cha Jamin, so Kriya Asaktyan Adhik, Bikatatapasya Adhik Cha Jamin, Dhigastu Brahma Ham, Badana Parifullana Jado Matina, Kim Etano Sachama Visayara Samatyana Naro Pasuna, Na Kesanchit Leshopi Ahaha Milita Gauru Madhyuna. Vanchakalpa Durvasya Kepasindhya Vyavacha Pachitanang Pavanabho Vaishnabhyo Namo.